Good morning, dear speakers, participants, ladies, gentlemen. My name is Inese Freimane-Deksne, and I will be the conference moderator. I would like to welcome you to this final Erasmus Plus Jean Monnet Conference organized by Riga Graduate School of Law. And for this conference, the title is Fundamental Rights at the Frontiers of the European Union, Looking for a New Balance. I wish to express a special gratitude to all speakers who agreed to contribute both to this conference and also to previous conferences under this project. Jean Monnet project has indeed been a very engaging, exciting, and challenging journey through different aspects of fundamental rights. We have looked at their protection both from public and private law perspective. We have analyzed them in the context of changing EU integration environment and the development of the EU as union of values. During previous three conferences under this project, we have explored spillovers and cross borders between constitutional law, consumer protection, competition, big data, and fundamental rights. This conference is considered to be as a follow-up conference, and it is also structured along the topics discussed during the previous conferences. During this project and during all the discussions we had, we have realized that not always we need a new legal regulation, but what we definitely need is a new balance. A new balance between common market objectives and fundamental rights, between national sovereignty and common European values, and between the public interest in development of new technologies and established value system in a democratic rule of law-based society. Today and tomorrow, we will try to find out how to strike this delicate balance and which aspects should be taken into account. It is also clear that the roles have changed. States are no longer the main data retainers. Processing of big data is done by powerful private actors such as Google, Facebook, Amazon, and it has also created challenges to competition law and increased risks for consumers in making well-informed decisions in these complex digital markets. At the same time, the Lisbon Treaty granted a legally binding status to the Charter of Fundamental Rights, and it seems that fundamental rights are gaining a new momentum within the EU. However, it should be also seen in the context of the changing relationship between the state and individual. The application of fundamental rights in a horizontal relationship between two private parties, like a company and individual, is becoming more frequent. A question arises, what is the responsibility of state? And how to ensure effective protection of fundamental rights in a situation of an imbalance of powers between an individual and powerful private actors. In addition to this, the EU is also confronted with a very challenging integration environment. There are political, economic, security challenges, both with the advent of Brexit and also in relations with neighbors of the European Union. When challenged with illegal immigration, economic crisis, terrorism, security risks, the EU member states are returning with reinforced calls for protection and respect of their national sovereignty. Interpretations of common values within the EU differ, and appeals to democracy, rule of law, and human rights continue to divide as much as to unite the EU member states and the EU institutions. The question is, do the EU funding treaties and Charter of Fundamental Rights create an appropriate system for checks and balances to ensure that national identities and common constitutional traditions of EU member states are respected? What is the role of a dialogue between the European courts and national courts in this regard? And maybe a starting point should be a recognition of interdependence of different legal orders, not a discussion of about their competition and supremacy. I hope that these and many war issues will be addressed during this conference, trying to reach some conclusions and provide also inspiring ideas for further legal debate. Before I give a floor to the for the opening statement to our acting rector, Mr. Professor Janis Ekstens, let me also provide you with some technical information. In line with conditions of the project grant, this conference is streamed on the RGSL portal and video recorded. The working language of the conference is English and no translation is provided. And each speaker will make an approximately 30 minutes long presentation, which will be followed by approximately 10 minutes questions and answers session. I wish you all of us a very successful conference, and now please join me in welcoming Professor Janis Ekstens, acting rector of Riga Graduate School of Law, for the opening statement. Please, Mr. Ekstens.